Excel English Academy, and today we will read the second chapter of class 7, A Play. In this chapter, through a play, through a drama, it has been displayed. The message has been displayed before us that what is corruption and how corruption is affecting our life as well as our society, okay, and how it will change our nature and attitudes towards the life. My dear students, if you go through the chapter line by line, find out the word meaning and write down in your copy. After this, it means besides this word meaning, you have to go through the line by line of your chapter and read carefully, find out the word meaning, then attempt the questions. Okay, this chapter is totally centralized on the topic, what is corruption? What is corruption? So before the start of the chapter, let us have recall the word stock of this chapter. Okay, see the word stock. First, advantage. Advantage means gain, profit. What is the advantage of this situation? We always heard. Okay. Obstruct. Obstruct means to stop. Stop is blockage. Okay. Second is concern. What is the concern? What is the worry? What is the fear? What is the problem? You may call what is the problem. Okay. Next one is authority. Authority means responsibility, governance. Whose responsibility is this? Whose authority is this? Okay. Or ombudsman. You have already heard this this word related to bank. And there is ombudsman who solve all the problems related to bank and likewise in other fields also. Concern fields. Okay. Instead, as an alternative, instead of, in place of. Okay. Now is secret. Secret means confidential, private, not open. Okay. Wisdom. Wisdom means knowledge, wiseness, and that is discretion. This means terminate, release, free. Ashamed. Ashamed means feeling sorry. I am feeling ashamed. It means I am feeling very guilty. I am feeling very sorry. Okay, my dear friends, now we will go through the introduction of this chapter. After that, we will give the answer of these questions. Then after, we will write the theme of this chapter. Okay, let's start. Please take out your book and go through the line by line with me. This is the class 7 book, textbook, and this is the chapter number 2. Half the price, sorry. This word mystique. Okay. Now let us start. Introduction. Corruption is the use of unethical methods to get some advantage by others. Unethical means illegal, not legal. It has become one of the big factors obstructing the development of individual and country. It means it is not affecting our life, but it also affects the development and progress of our country also and society also. It is concerned with it is concerned with unnecessary and wrong use of both power and position. It means the corruption arises from where there is power and authority. If I have authority, then I may commit the corruption. Okay? Or if I have not power, then how I can do the corruption? So, my dear friends, those who is in power, he only can practice the corruption in his field, either in any field. There may be the corruption in the field of your studies. Suppose, if any teacher is teaching you or misguiding you, that is another type of corruption. Because corruption tells us that not ethical, or it is the responsibility of our teachers to teach the good education to the students. If I am teaching, then I am doing the corruption. Okay? See. It is concerned with unnecessary and wrong use of both power and position by anyone. Okay? Power and position. Position, it means I am a headmaster. Power, I can do it. It is under my control. It is under my position. And if I am not doing according to the legal laws, whatever the rules, then that is called corruption. Anyone, whether in the government or non-government organization, the story below is related to corruption at higher authorities. Higher authority means, students mention two things. Corruption is generally committed by those who have power and position, and second one is generally practiced by the upper authorities, not lower authorities. How I can do if I don't have power? The general labor, general teachers, or general anyone, anywhere in any field can't do any corrupt activities. It will be done only by those who have powers. Okay? See. Read and enjoy the story. Once there lived a fisherman in a town near the Arabian Sea. Okay? He was a wise old fisherman. The fisherman had a daughter. She was 17 years old. That was the age of marriage for girls in those days. So the fisherman was looking for a good bridegroom for his daughter. It means the fisherman had a daughter and she was at the age of marriage, and that's why the fisherman was searching for a bridegroom. He found several young men, but he didn't have enough money to get his daughter married to one of them. Some of his friends advised him to see the Raja who ruled the town and ask him for help. It means he didn't know where he had to go, and someone advised him, go to the Raja, he will surely help. He was ready to take their advice, but he didn't wish to go to the Raja without any gifts. He wished to take him with a gift that was good enough for the Raja. It means now the fisherman came to know that I have to visit the Raja, but he thought, I would not go before the Raja, or I can't meet Raja without any gift. Okay? What gift could a fisherman give except fish? But the fisherman was too old to go far out into the sea. Every day he saw several big fish in the sea and tried to catch one, but he failed. Then one day he was lucky. A very big fish fell into his net, and he immediately set off for the Raja's palace with great joy. But at the palace gate, the gatekeeper stopped him. It means he was old, he didn't used to catch the fish, but one day when he caught the big fish, then he thought, I must visit to the king with this fish as a gift. Gatekeeper, you can't go in. Fisherman, but I must see the Raja. I wish to give him this fish as a gift. It means he told the gatekeeper, I have to visit or I have to meet the Raja because I have to give him the gift. Gatekeeper, you need God. You need not give him any fish. He has enough fish for several days. Fisherman, but I must speak to the Raja. I want to speak to him about an important matter. It means he told the gatekeeper that I have to meet the king because I have to discuss important matter with him. Gatekeeper, you need not to speak to the Raja. You can speak to me instead. Fisherman, I do not wish to speak to you about it. Gatekeeper, why can't you speak to me? It is a secret. I can keep secrets. The gatekeeper is scolding or pressing him to told me what is the matter. And the fisherman said, I can't tell you. So let me go in. And the gatekeeper said, what's it? Let us see. Fisherman, you need not keep my secret and you must not stop me here. Everyone in the town can see the Raja at any time. The Raja himself said so. I hear. I know anyone can visit or anyone can meet the Raja at any time. So you can't stop me. Gatekeeper, but I am sorry, you are wrong. The Raja has ordered me not to let anyone in now and I must obey his order. I will not let him in. The king has said me that don't allow anyone to enter. So I can't allow you to enter in the room or enter into the palace where the king is sitting. Please, fisherman, please let me in. I must see the Raja and give him the fish. Gatekeeper, do you want to sell him the fish? What is its price? What is its price? Gatekeeper, do you want to sell? It means the gatekeeper thought he wants to visit the king and meet the king because he wants to sell his fish. And he asked, what is the price? Fisherman, I am not selling it. I am giving it to the Raja. Gatekeeper, but still he will certainly pay a good price for it. Now, shall we divide the money between us? Will you give me the half price? It means the gatekeeper thought, if he is not selling, then the king would certainly, surely will reward him or pay him some money. And he put a condition, imposed a condition against him that if you got the price, then you must have to share the half of the price. Fisherman, how can I do that? Gatekeeper, you need not do that and you need not to go in now. Fisherman, what shall I do now? Gatekeeper, you can do one of the two things, either give me half the price or leave the place and go. You have two options, either give me the half price or leave the palace. Okay, the fisherman stood there for some time and thinking. Fisherman was thinking, what I can do now. Fisherman, will you take half of the anything that the Raja gives me? Then fisherman asked, will you take whatever the Raja will give me? You will take the half one, whatever he gives. Gatekeeper, he will give you either gold or silver. What else will he give you? He will either give you the gold or silver. I am ready to take it. Fisherman, I don't know anything about that. Answer my question. Will you take half of anything I get from the Raja? I don't know what will he reward me. But are you ready to take whatever he will give me, half of it? Gatekeeper, yes. I shall take anything. Now you can go in. Now the terms and conditions put up by the gatekeeper has been accepted by the fisherman, and according to condition the deal has been finalized between the gatekeeper and fisherman, that whatever the Raja will reward to the fisherman, that half of it will be shared with the guard. And the gatekeeper thought the Raja will surely give either silver or gold. And I am always ready. Gatekeeper, yes, I shall take anything. Now you can go in. It means now you can go in. Fisherman, thank you very much. I shall certainly give you half the price I get the for the fisher for the fish. Okay, surely will get. The fisherman appeared before the Raja with his big bag, big fish. He placed the fish with great respect at the Raja's feet. It means now the with honor, the fisherman put the fish in front of the king in the feet. Fisherman, I have long wished to see you, your highness, and pay my respect to you, but I didn't come till now because I was not able to find a gift that was good enough for you. Today, I was lucky enough to catch this. Oh, and the fisherman said, the king, that I wish to meet you, but I have no proper gift for you, and today I have caught this big fish for you, and now I am here for you. Okay? Raja, what is your name? What is your name? My name, fisherman, my name is Jalraj, your highness. My name is Jalraj. Raja, I have heard of you, all fishermen respect you, and see that you are the wisest among them, and respect all good and wise men among my people. So, please sit down and tell me everything about this fish. It means the Raja now respect the fisherman and told him, please take your seat and tell me why you have visited to me. Fisherman, it is a fish that lives in the deep sea far below the surface of water. It sometimes comes up and jumps several feet above the water. It came up with this morning and fell this morning and fell into my net. Now it is here before you. Send it to your cooks immediately and you will enjoy your dinner today. Now the fisherman told the king that this is the special kind of fish and I have caught it today morning and now it is before you. Send it immediately to the cook, to the kitchen so that it will be cooked for you for today's dinner. Raja, stay for dinner and enjoy with us, my man. I invite you to dine in the palace today. Now, what shall I give you in return for this gift? Now, the actual point, the real point has arrived. In spite of presenting a gift, the king asked what you want as a gift from me. As a gift from me. Fisherman, nothing, your highness and everybody in the palace must enjoy my gift. That is all I want. I don't want anything. Your respect, you have respected me and you have admitted me. That is the big things and you all of you will enjoy. This is I want. Raja, no, that is not enough. No. You must get something in return. You must get something in return. Fisherman, then will your highness give me anything I ask for? Can you give me anything I ask? Who told the fisherman to the king? Raja, yes, anything, whatever you want. Fisherman then ordered your men to give me 200 lashes with a whip on my back. Then the fisherman asked, please ask your man to give me 200 lashes. Lashes means kora, with a whip on my back. Whip means hard. Whip means hard. Whip means a long thin piece of leather. It means having the long rope and having 200 kora upon my back. Okay? Raja, what a strange request this is. What? 200 lashes? 200 kora? What is the request? This is the strange. People say you are a wise man, but I don't think your request shows any wisdom. That what fun will you get out of lashes on your back? Log kahte hain that you are great one, but it shows that you have no mind and what it will give you if you have 200 lashes on your back. Would you like to tell me something? Or is there any secret meaning in your demand? Fisherman, you and your men can get some fun watching the lesson me man lesson me. I'm sure you will get some laughing stock, and you will enjoy my having the lashes on my back. So I am demanding it, Raja. But I don't want to have such fun. Ask me for something else. But I don't like to. I don't like such type of fun. Please ask something else. Anything else? Whatever you want. Fisherman, I do not wish for anything else, Your Highness. I don't want anything else. Raja, all right. Then you will have your lashes. Have your lashes. Are you ready for them? Okay, as you like it. Are you ready to get the lashes on your back? Fisherman, yes, I am, Your Highness. I'm ready, always ready. But please call your keeper in. Before that, call your gatekeeper. The Raja sent his men to the gatekeeper, and in a few moments he appears. And within no span of time, the men called the gatekeeper and produced before the king. Okay, Fisherman, Your Highness, please give this man 100 lashes out of 200 lashes that you have promised me. Gatekeeper, what? 100 lashes? Why must I share this punishment with you? Why I will share it with you? Fisherman, we agreed to divide the price of the feast between us. It is the deal you have made. And after that, you have allowed me to enter in the palace. This was the condition put up by you. You wanted half of anything I got from the Raja in return for it. I'm getting 200 lashes from him, and half of the 200 is 100. You have told you want half of this, half of the prices or rewards. Raja, no, not 100. Give the gatekeeper all the 200 lashes and dismiss him from my service. I feel ashamed because I kept such a bad servant all these days. You are indeed very wise, my good fisherman. This man was trying to cheat you. You have very cleverly brought punishment on him. I wish to give you a good reward for your cleverness and wisdom. Ask me anything. It means now the king is very pleased with the fisherman, and he understood all the things, all the matters, and said, you are very, very clever, and you have caught the corrupt person from my court, and that he is the gatekeeper, and you have done the good job, and that's why I would like to give you the reward on your demands, and according to your demands, whatever you will ask, you can ask me or demand me. Fisherman, I have a daughter, and I must soon give her away in marriage. I am very poor. Now the fisherman told the real story to the king, that I have a daughter and I want to get her married. I am very poor. Raja, bring here the bridegroom of your choice. I shall get her married. Please bring her, call her the bridegroom before me. Fisherman, I thank your highness. Now the fisherman told me, thank you, sir, and thank you for your cooperation. And with this, our chapter has come to an end. Okay, after we have already read the chapter line by line, after that, we will answer what is corruption. We have already, corruption is the unethical, the already this has been given. Corruption is the use of unethical methods to get some advantage by others. It is the unethical It is the use of, it is the unethical method, methods to get some advantages by others. Okay, I hope you have understood all the things. After that, we have to write the theme of the play. The theme of the play is the what is corruption and significance and effects of the corruption upon our society as well as ourselves. What is corruption and how it is affecting our life or society. Okay, my dear students, hope you have understood all the things. Till then, take care, and I would like to tell you in the Hindi so that you could understand very well and having without any doubts. Okay, without any doubt. एक fisherman था और बहुत ही अच्छा था नेचर का और बुढ़े था विद्वान था. उसको एक बच्ची की शादी करनी थी और वो परेशान था और बच्ची की शादी करने के लिए उसको पता नहीं चल रहा था कि बच्चा कहाँ से ढूंढे, मतलब लड़का कहाँ से ढूंढे. और उसी लड़का को ढूंढने के लिए एक तब फिर लोगों ने उनको सजेस्ट किया कि आप जाकर राजा से मिलिए, वो आपकी प्योर श्योर हेल्प करेंगे. वो जाता भी है और गेट पर उसको गेट कीपर जाने नहीं देता है और एक गिफ्ट लेकर जाता है, बड़ा सा मछली पकड़कर. ठीक, अब गेट कीपर कहता है कि तुम गिफ्ट लाए हो, ठीक है, राजा तुमको कुछ गिफ्ट देंगे रिटर्न में. तो जो भी राजा देंगे और राजा आपको जो चीज भी गिफ्ट में देंगे, सोना चांदी, आप हमको आधा दीजिएगा, तभी हम आपको जाने देंगे, अदरवाइज नहीं जाने देंगे. तो कहते ठीक है देंगे. अब वो फिशरमैन जाता है कोर्ट में और राजा से मांग करता है कि मुझे 200 घोड़ी, क्या बोलते, कोड़े चाहिए, 200 कोड़े मुझे मारो पीछे. तो अब राजा कहता है ये क्या डिमांड है, तुमको ये मांगने के लिए तो हम नहीं बोले थे, तुम कुछ अच्छा मांगो, सोना चांदी कुछ भी मांगो. तो कहता नहीं मुझे यही चाहिए. तो ठीक, तो कहता लगाओ इसको 200 कोड़े. तो फिर गेट कीपर कहता है अच्छा ठीक है, हमको फिटनेस पहले गेट कीपर को बुलाओ. गेट कीपर को कहता है ठीक है, इसको 100 कोड़ा मारो. कहता क्यों 100 कोड़ा क्यों? कहता है क्योंकि हमारे तुम्हारे बीच में डील हुआ था कि जो जो भी प्राइज मिलेगा, रिवार्ड मिलेगा, उसका हाफ शेयर होगा और 100 लाइसेंस को मिलेगा. तब राजा बोलता है 100 नहीं, इसको 200 मारो, इसको सर्विस से हटा दो, टर्मिनेट करो, ये करप्ट आदमी है. और क्या बोलते हैं, फिशरमैन को थैंक यू बोलता है कि तुमने एक करप्ट पर्सन को कॉट आउट किया एंड यू हैव डन द ग्रेट जॉब एंड डिमांड बी व्हाट एवर यू लाइक, तुम मांगो मुझसे जो मांगते हो. तो कहता है सर मुझे कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, सिर्फ मुझे अपनी बच्ची की शादी करनी है, इसके लिए लड़का ढूंढना. तो कहता ठीक है लड़का को इसको लाओ, मैं शादी करवा देता हूँ. और अब इसके बाद आती है कि हम लोग क्या सीखे. हम लोग यही सीखते हैं कि आखिर भ्रष्टाचार क्या होता है, करप्शन क्या होता है. करप्शन उसको बोलते हैं जब आप किसी से कुछ भी अपने पावर पोजीशन का मिस यूज करते हैं टू गेट सम एडवांटेज, दैट इज कॉल्ड करप्शन. थैंक यू, टेक केयर एंड प्लीज डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड शेयर इट ऑल्सो.